All right, this is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today, I have a special treat for you. What we're seeing here is actually called walking stick kale, also known as Jersey kale. So you can see there when I ordered this kale, you know, it said it grows really tall, and I was hoping it would be something like my basically tree kale that I have here growing next to it, which is actually towers over the walking stick kale. I mean, geez, my tree kale is pushing over 6 feet. The walking stick kale, you know, definitely about 4 feet tall. And the walking stick kale is actually from the Channel Islands. And back, it's been grown, you know, over 200 years over there. And they'd use it for animal fodder, so for animal feed. The sheep or the cows would like it. Nowadays they grow it and they feed it to their rabbits. It does definitely have a strong kale-like taste. I mean, this stuff looks prehistoric. I actually had the postman come up who has dragons for pets. Yeah, that's bearded dragons for pets. And he says, man, my bearded dragons, they love kale. And I mean, look at this. I mean, what could look more prehistoric than some kale? I mean, here's another one. So the thing with these guys is that you really need to train them and make them straight. This one's luckily pretty straight here. This one is actually pretty straight here. And some of the ones, you know, I haven't paid too much attention to. You know, they're getting a little bit curved. So, you know, hopefully these will make some nice walking sticks one day. They can get up to 18 feet tall from what I hear. So we'll see how tall it gets. We're just going to let them grow. Nice, gets a nice woody stem here at the bottom. And these kale leaves are nice and huge kale leaves. Now these kale leaves are really strong, but you know, definitely I don't use them as animal food. I like to eat them. They're definitely good. The bugs, you can see, kind of like them too. And I prefer to pick the smaller inner leaves. So, you know, the baby leaves there for, you know, eating out of hand. I actually just chop them up and put them into salads myself. I suppose you could cook them if you wanted to, but you're going to kill all the enzymes when you cook your kale and, you know, degrade some of the nutrients. So I recommend eating everything raw. You could also, you know, with these big leaves, what I like to do, you know, is just take them off and add them to a juice. So add like one big leaf to a juice of maybe like something like there's a lemon cucumber there. So we could juice some lemon cucumbers with some kale, maybe some celery and apples. Makes a really nice juice. So once again, this is John Kohler with Growing Your Greens, growing Jersey kale, also known as walking stick kale here. Nice prehistoric look. Not to get confused with the tree kale I have over here. Actually, the tree kale tastes much, much better. So if you're going to grow one or the other, grow the tree kale that has the basically purple stem with the purple variegated purple vein leaves. They're much better tasting. These can be only propagated by cuttings. And the walking stick kale, I did start from seeds. So this is John Kohler with another episode of GrowingYourGreens.com. And remember, you can grow your own greens. And check out these tall tree kales.